Sorry, I haven't even had a chance to look at this yet. You know, kind of the same thing I said after the Bellarmine game. I was really proud of our guys, the way they were resilient from a defensive standpoint with, you know, we couldn't throw the ball in the ocean in the first half. We got, I think we were 1 for 10, but I think all 10 of them were great wide open looks, and we just didn't make them. But we kept defending. We had 23, I think, deflections at halftime. I think we ended up with 38 for the game. So, you know, that's a heck of a basketball team. I was really impressed watching them on film, but even after watching them in person, I mean, that was a very, very good team, which we knew was going to be coming in. But, you know, I thought our guys did a good job of staying in there, staying tough, even when we got down there late in the second half. And, you know, we hit a couple of big shots. Needless to say, Jordan came in, Darius came in, gave us some great minutes, and, you know, we're 1-0. So that's what it's all about, and we'll take it.
David, were you nervous? Did you sleep last night?
Well, unfortunately, I got wrapped up in a couple of those football games. That Alabama game was something else. But I got a couple hours, you know. You know, I woke up this morning and I was really ready to go, and it seemed like, even though it was a 2 o'clock tip, it seemed like it was about 9 o'clock by the time the game rolled around. You know, I was anxious. And I think our guys had some nerves too. You know, just exhibition games are good, but they're not real games. You know, you know it counts. It's just a different feel. But, you know, I'm glad it's out of the way now. And most importantly, I'm glad we're 1-0. So.
Watching football help take the edge off
last night? Yeah, I mean, I love college football. It's probably my second favorite sport. But, you know, it's just, I tried to get some sleep. I just couldn't. But, you know, I woke up ready to go this morning. But most importantly, our guys seemed to wake up ready to go, too.
Orders in your first game as a player or as a coach?
I don't remember my first game as a player, but I'm sure I was a lot more nervous as a player because I had impact on the actual game. But no, I had some nerves, but I knew that game was going to be like that. I mean, they were a very disciplined team. They knew we started to switch. They made some really good adjustments, and what they basically ended up doing was just saying, okay, we're just going to go one-on-one and take you. Now, we messed up a couple times in the second half where we let a guy go to a strong hand, or the one time I almost had a heart attack when Honest didn't have his hands out on the kid that had made 4 threes up to that point. So, you know, it's just little things like that we got to correct, but all things considered, for first time out, not bad.
What was your thinking in putting Jordan and Darius in when you did?
Well, I thought Darius gave us some good minutes in the first half. I thought we made that run there where we got the crowd into the game and went up a couple. I think we were up 4. He was in the game. And then obviously in the second half, you know, we couldn't, I mean, we were getting good looks. We just could not make one. And that's going to happen. And so I said, well, if that's one thing Jordan can do, it's he can shoot the ball. And if he misses one, he's not going to be shy. He's going to keep shooting it. But luckily he made his first one, and, you know, he's kind of off to the races.
Do you give up anything defensively with those two?
I mean, we will, just from an experience standpoint, but I thought Darius did a really, really good job of staying in front of the ball. You know, he's the quickest guy on the team for sure, you know, from a lateral standpoint. So I thought he did a good job. You know, we made some mistakes defensively as a team, but again, playing against a team like that, it's kind of like a, you know, a Bellarmine type where all of a sudden if you make one mistake, now you got to scramble, you got to rotate, and then everybody's out of position. But that, you know, that is a heck of a basketball team. Very happy with our win today.
It really seemed like Mason tried to discourage going into the paint early, and you guys kind of went away from it. But the second half, it seemed like you were really content on getting the ball into the paint, wanting to kind of force the issue. Is that something that you talked about?
It was, yeah. That was a big point for us, even after Bellarmine. You know, we didn't throw the ball inside enough. You know, the first play of the game tonight, we drew it up to get Ray the ball inside. A, to see how they were going to play us, and B, just to make a point of getting the ball inside. And, you know, I think we reversed it to the wing, reversed it, somebody got a wide open three in the corner, and that's how you got to play, inside to out. You know, unfortunately, we missed a couple easy ones around the rim. Ray had missed a couple easy ones, and, you know, he missed a dunk, Honest missed an easy one. But, you know, that's got to be a staple of our team, is playing inside to out, because that opens up the perimeter. You know, we can't just come down and just run ball screens and just pass and shoot all the time. We got to play inside to out because we have good post players.
Do you feel the need to say anything to VJ and Ray, struggling offensively where they did?
Or? No, they'll be fine. I think both guys maybe were pressing a little bit. No, I don't know that for sure, but I just kind of got the feel that, you know, dang, even though he wasn't shooting the ball well, the most impressive thing to me so far has been the way he's just let the game come to him. You know, he's not trying to force it too early. Now, I know he missed a couple easy ones to start the game, but he stays with it. You know, I think Ray and VJ just might be pressing for whatever reason a little bit too much, but they're going to be fine. They're too talented. They're too good of kids. They work too hard. They're going to be fine.
One game, it didn't appear that you were on the referees very much. Is that likely to be a pattern?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'll just calmly say something to him if I see something. I mean, it's a referee is the most thankless job in sports. I mean, there's no question. And you know, Jamie and John Gaffney, I've known those guys for a long time. I mean, they even officiated when I was playing. So, you know, I just try to talk to them in a calm way. I mean, I'm not going to try to show them out or anything like that. But, you know, I thought that the game was pretty well officiated. And, you know, that moving, you know, it's just, like I said, refs have the most thankless job in sports. I would not want to be a ref. It's tough. They're going to miss calls. They're going to make right calls. But, you know, overall, I thought it was pretty well officiated.
Are you conscious when you're standing that you're blocking somebody's view?
Not anymore. No, honestly, Tim, that's the first two exhibition games I was. Bellarmine, I got a little bit more, but tonight I was like, I don't care. I was like, I got to coach my team. I got to win. I don't care. Get some seats higher up. And, you know, but no, it's the only person I'm really blocking most of the time is Kenny. I don't care if he sees anyway. So.
You got rid of the towel today, too.
You know, I feel like, well, I didn't even realize this until after Bellarmine. I didn't realize I could go 6 feet up farther. I knew they changed the rule to where you could be closer to half court, but for some reason, I just wasn't paying attention, and I thought the first line, they just moved it. But then I was like, I was watching a game on Friday, and I was like, wait a second, I can go all the way up there. And so, I mean, I have like 8 different spots where I was taking a knee, and I was trying to be courteous to Paul and Bob, because I know last game, I mean, the microphone is like right here, and I probably said a couple of choice words, but, you know, I was on the move a lot today, and I broke a serious sweat, so.
Down 3 at halftime, what did you tell your team in the locker room?
I told him, I said, look, relax, guys. I said, we're 1-for-10 from 3. All 10 threes were wide open looks. We're a very good shooting team. Law of average, it will start to fall. It will start to fall. And we were 7-10 in the second half. So there you go. I said 7-8 actually in the locker room, but we were 7-10. And, you know, you just got to stay patient. The most important thing is keep getting good looks. And B, even if you can't make it, can't let it affect your defense. And I thought for the most part we held true to that.
Darius and Jordan's points, they seem to hit some shots in very big moments of the game, and even Malik hitting 2 free throws in an important time of the game. How much can they draw on this when the season does get into full swing, when you're in the middle of the season? How much can they already draw back on the experience in this game?
Yeah, I mean, it goes back to practice. I mean, they've been practicing well. Malik even been practicing pretty well this week. I know he didn't get as many minutes probably as he had hoped, but he came in, made 2 huge free throws. You know, it's going to be an adjustment for those guys, because obviously in high school they play all 32 minutes. That's not going to be the case here. But, you know, they came in. I thought the most impressive thing with Darius was he took pride in his defense. You know, and that's what we've been hitting home with him. Just, you got to be a Russ Smith, Peyton Siva type player on defense and just be a pit bull, and he's really taken that to heart.
Even though he didn't have big numbers, Quinn Snyder seemed like every time your guys kind of got a little rattled, he'd have like a layup or kind of calm the team down. What's it mean to have that senior point guard out there to kind of stay?
Well, you know, the most impressive thing looking at the stat sheet about Q is he had 6 rebounds. You know, if your point guard can have 6 rebounds, I know he didn't have a great shooting night. But again, Q, VJ, Ray, even Honest, those guys will be fine. Okay, they didn't have a very good night tonight. You know, they didn't shoot it great, but that's going to happen. They know. They've been through college basketball for 2-3 years now, and that's just part of the game. But, you know, I told Q, we did a good job executing our press-o there when Darius got fouled and he cut over the top. But then the next time, I think they missed a shot or something. And Q let Darius get the ball in bounds, and Q was running up the court. I said, go get the ball. I said, I love Darius, but you need to go get the ball. I mean, the ball's got to be in his hands because he's going to make the right decision. He understands time and score, and you know he's got that coaching mindset.
David, I know this one game, but what can you do with Honest in the mindset when he's on the line? As far as it seemed like once he missed his first one, he just wasn't very confident after that.
Yeah, I mean, we've worked really, really hard all spring and summer. He's actually been shooting it really well in practice. You know, free throws are all mental. I mean, you can change form here and there, but it's confidence. You know, and that's why I'm never going to say something to them for missing a free throw, because they're not trying to miss it. You know, and big thing with him is if he misses 1 or 2, maybe he starts to get a little nervous and start to think. But, you know, we just got to keep working on it. But, you know, Malik came in a crucial situation, made 2 big ones.
Questions, David. One, how conscious were you of trying to be positive with those guys? And then secondly, will you be almost exclusively man-to-man this year, or do you plan on playing zone?
No, I thought about going zone there for a minute in the second half when, you know, we couldn't keep them in front of us off the bounce. But I just said, look, they're going to start missing. We'll hit a couple. It'll even out and just stay with it. But no, I mean, we'll mix it up. We just haven't worked on our zone very much. We've wanted to really get the young guys to understand how we play man-to-man defense instead of throwing 2 different things at them, and now they're confused. But we'll work on it. But, you know, the reason I was so positive with them is because I knew we were getting good looks. We just weren't making them. And there's nothing you can do about that. As long as we're taking open good looks, they'll fall. You just got to continue to share the ball and get good looks.
Is there a point today when you heard Coach Pitino's voice in your head?
No, but I did find myself stomping the floor a few times. I don't know if you guys heard it or not, but you know, I guess old habits die hard from people you learn it from. But I knew we were going to be fine. I kept telling them in timeouts, guys, we're going to be fine. We're going to hit a couple. We're going to be fine. Just keep getting stops. Keep getting stops.
How nice is it to have this virtual for you?
Yeah, I think for all of us, you know, it's almost like a, not of the weight of the world off our shoulders, but just a relief. You know, for six weeks today, you know, we've been practicing, getting ready for this game, and now that it was finally here, I think, you know, we were anxious. Some of us had a little bit of nerves, but now we can just get into the routine of games moving forward.
Anything else?
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.